So
she doesn't know a stranger.
And I can show you my closet.
She has a very big personality.
It is huge.
She likes to be the center of attention.
Hi.
She likes to be on stage. She was born at Duke with spina bifida, which we knew before she was born.
But in the end, you just, you know, dads want to protect their daughters. So you wish you could do it for them, but you can't.
Progressively, her scoliosis has gotten worse, and Dr. Lark had been watching her very closely. As she got older and taller, her back became more and more compressed, just because her spine couldn't hold the weight.
So we initially tried to brace her and control her curve with a brace, but the scoliosis was more powerful than our braces, and she couldn't tolerate the brace, so we had to explore other options.
He came to us and said, hey, I want to talk to you about this new product on the market, and how would you like to be first to try it out? Because he felt like Aubrey was the perfect candidate.
It was not about the procedure, it was about where this fit in Aubrey's plan.
The MAGEC rod is a magnetically lengthenable rod for children that still need to achieve some spinal growth. And the advantage of that is, theoretically, you can implant it with one surgery and then not require any further surgeries to lengthen the rod.
Oh, she's 100 times straighter.
Teresa.
Before, she had to wear a TLSO, which is a brace along her core.
My brace that I used to have to wear, it was not very comfortable. And I'm happy that I don't have to wear it anymore.
And she wasn't able to dress herself because she couldn't put the brace on herself.
These are three of my dresses.
So now, without having to wear the brace, she can get up, she can choose her clothes and take her shirt on and off.
I can wear dresses and anything I want to that has sailboats on it.
So to see her just progress and to continue to learn and grow and develop, that makes me proud.
It has a bow.
We put a little device on her back that turns a magnetic motor, and it takes about 20 minutes to lengthen her 4.7 millimeters, and we'll do that every 3 months.
I call Dr. Lark my best friend because he's done everything for me.
Yeah, that brings a little tear, to be honest. I haven't heard that before, but Aubrey's a very special child, and we've developed a good relationship over the years, and so it's nice to hear that we have a relationship more than just doctor-patient.
The medical staff at Duke has turned a lifelong Tar Heel into a Duke fan, and that's pretty rare.
Close.
I learn things from Aubrey every day. I consistently call her my hero because of what she's been through.
I'm really proud of her as her mom, and she's a pretty amazing kid.